What's going on, everybody? Happy Friday night, afternoon-ish, morning, or, you know, wherever, what day ever it is. Okay, so, what we're doing today is a Fallout video. Updates available. Do we need to update this again? We need to update this one again. Okay, we updated that one again. Okay, so, today we're going to be doing a Fallout one. For their video, and today we are just going to be showing you our mods here that we have installed. So we have the armor, weapon, the power armor, wasteland, android outfits, wedges, power armor, busty, more unique weapons, legend NPC, rickety restored sanctuary bridge, Dr. Mobius, 5-time long wires, more settlements, gas mask with helmets, brotherhood, Railroad, Minutemans, and Synth Guards, Morfair, Ghouls, you can look through these and see the ones I have. I have this one in my library, but I'm not currently using it, so the down arrow means it's downloaded, check mark means it's activated. So I have used this at one point. Now this is going to be one we're going to be taking a close look at, is the Dismemberment Overhaul. And wacky weapons, we will be using that. I will be putting in a little warning with this one. You won't be able to see what I'm talking about for the warning till the very end. So we're just gonna see what the featured are today, and nothing really there. Most popular today. Cheats pack. Toolbox contains 50k, 50, 60k, mole rat poison, type 54. If someone is wondering if they can hear music in the background, the music in the background is a Suicide Boys track. Ring of the End, cheap combat uniform. Jesus, fuck. Yeah, this is cheap. That's not even fun. Let's look at this. Ballistic Realism Overhaul. From the great feedback, guns do 200 to 1,800 plus damage. This does not mean you will one-shot everything. No more bullet sponges, though. This does not mean you will one-shot everything, but I'm assuming he means no more bullet sponges. Upgrade your weapons to change gameplay. At first, the game may seem difficult. Once you start to upgrade your weapons and armor, you are truly a force to be reckoned with. Also, check out Bullet Time, my favorite mod. Chance that's not on here. Okay, so we may do a realistic version then with this guy here, but I'm going to do that later. That's definitely something. Let's see. We'll favorite that. That way we know where how to find it. And that's it for today. I updated everybody. That's what it was. Okay, so this is just going to be kind of like a funny video and whatnot. And, you know, and stuff. In preparation for, like, Fallout 76, which hopefully will be an amazing game. I have high hopes for it. So today we're going to go into, let's go into Tetsuo, who was just a person we decided to use purely for the adventure of trying out this thing called the West Mod. Oh shit. We may not actually be able to use Tetsuo. I think I deleted everything for this. Yeah, okay. Can't use that then. We'll just go to the one that I've been using then. And we shall go to that. Which, yes, I know, I'm using all mods, but don't worry. I've beaten the game beforehand. Before using all this, and I've actually gotten a good amount of trophies. I've done the Brotherhood of Steel playthrough, mostly. I've done the Minuteman playthrough, saving all of them. I believe I saved all the Brotherhood besides the Institute. Minuteman saved all besides the Institute. This one's going to be doing the Institute, but it's modded. Whoops. I haven't done the Railroad yet, or the Institute without mods, just because I'm not a huge fan of the Railroad. Institute, I just never got around to doing it. But, if there's one thing I wish the actual creators of, like, the original Fallout would do, is more weapon variants. Say hello to Nick Valentine, my synth commando from Volt 81, because this is the closest Volt towards his hometown. Okay, so this is my character here. Say hello to Vlad. So yeah, I also have mods so I can put on... Hello? So yes, this is actually a short... This is actually the wacky weapon. I actually have a couple on me, so... I also have some flares, which those are cool. These are acting like grenades, but they're actually... You chuck them, and they become flares. So they actually can, like, light a room, which that's cool. But there's a more realistic version where it, like, darkens it, the lights and everything. That'd be cool. So yeah, see, Hunter's Rifle. So I can show you that later, what those are. And then see, this is a plasma-infused revolver. And this is a Skillzer's gun, which I haven't used yet. And then see, I have all these, which if you come out here and look at my character, hey, he's a robot. So actually, if you look at really closely.
Hey.
I'm all ears.
Wait there.
I'll stay put.
So, Synth is, yeah, this is Synth. No, this is Nick Valentine, and I can show you real quick what he would look like. But this is him with my modded gear on.
Hey,
because
do something for
you? Change his outfit, so I have a mod on for him so that I can get rid of the trench coat and add different stuff and all that. So he is currently using a customized plasma-infused wacky assault sniper rifle. And so this is what he would originally look like. I'm not gonna go out just because I don't want to, but that would be his original look. So this is what he looks at with no outfit on at all. This is what he would look like, except I believe he has a pipe revolver. So the hand is actually, this is the, that's the hand, but that's what he's supposed to look like, so that will add a hand. And then I don't have any mods on the actual armor itself, I don't believe. Nothing out of the ordinary. So that's the customizations I've done for him.
Hey,
what's
come on.
Plan? Who needs help?
So this is a custom hunting rifle, like I was saying. The only annoying part is... Oh, wait, that's me. I forgot that I changed. Okay. So you can actually change yourself to be a synth. And all that. The one I really like to use so far is the Hollow Gen 6. G2 eyes, which all it does is change your eyes, but you can't really tell. I mean, I could also add on the hands, but if it was only one, that would be cool, but it changes both, which that's unfortunate. So we don't use that one. But they're also pretty balanced in the sense of, like, defensive stats, I feel. Okay, so we're going to go... let's go to Red Rocket. This is the place I've been using as my my like own area. I very rarely have this area set up as an actual settlement. I actually use this area as like my home base. Like this is my home base. This is where I come to in like almost every single gameplay and walkthrough I do and whatnot. Is that I always come to this place. This is always my starting location. Okay. So I'm not going to be showcasing all my mods. Like, here's a mod there on the chest piece. This is modified. This is actually a century gun, 50 caliber round. So that's actually uses 50 calibers instead of the standard 5mm. No other mods really around. This is a mod. This is the railroad paint job mod for like every single armor I had installed. So if you come into here, the chemistry station, and use, like, this is our FM stuff so that we can make anything we want. But we're going to try something here. This is going to be a fun test. Let's get a behemoth. And then let's get a deathclaw. Now if we can get some people that won't die. That won't kill me. Maybe railroad agents? Maybe railroad agents. I don't know. I think Minuteman may be what we go with because there's not many. Okay, so we'll grab a couple of these. Cheat chest weapons. Dead you. Now we're gonna come down to here. Let's see, what do we wanna showcase here? Let's go with the combat shotgun. And the, not the fat man, not that, not the Gatling laser, not the junk jet. Maybe the junk jet, why not? Let's see. Laser gun, laser musket, laser minigun, missile launcher. And I think that will be our choices. Yeah, that's how. Okay, so also since we're doing something I have planned here, we need to come down to here and go to S. And we're going to want some stealth boys. And the only reason we need stealth boys is because this will allow me to just watch and not have to be involved. Because when I use those sproners, they will attack me. So this is a custom pistol I have, which I also want to talk about. If they could do something in Fallout 76, that would be awesome. Is more weapon choices. And on top of that, is an actual modification or, you know, little DLC or whatever. So that you can use dual wield pistols. So, you know, you can use like the 10mm double. Okay, this is just whatever song is playing. This is actually just a Suicide Boys playlist, that's all this is. So you can actually come into here and change whatever you want. Now that's a big freaking gun. This has a range of negative 75. How can I have a range of negative? Like, you can get very, very weird with what happens. So like for instance, let's see, what do we want to make this shotgun into? Uh, I think we're gonna do something like that. Let's see. And the main reason I downloaded this mod in particular is that I really wanted to change the change the Thompson, the submachine gun, because the only magazines it had was the giant circle ones, and I'm a fan of the square ones, and that's the only reason I had that. See, so we could add whatever we want to this. We're just gonna do the quick eject, and then we can add whatever we want on top of this. I'm thinking maybe the assault rifle. That wouldn't be bad, but it is off to the right, and I don't like it. If it was on the middle, I would definitely choose that. Here, we're going to use this. That bad. And then the muzzle. What do we want the muzzle? This thing is absolutely ginormous. Okay, we're gonna use the shotgun muzzle brake. Oh god! Okay, so now we can choose whatever override we want. So we could have the MIRV, minigun, missile, plasma, RR spike, shotgun, surrender. We can even have different rounds. Let's make this alien blaster. And then we're going to change the actual shotgun. We'll come all the way down to shotgun, and we're going to use the advanced automatic one. Automated receiver. Armor piercing one. There you go. And then you could even add something to this, like we're going to add on violence. So it's 25% more limb damage, but has more recoil. And to make this even funner, we're gonna make it even more violent. You know what? Just because I feel like... Let's make this a shotgun shell. Okay, let's see what we can do with you, shall we? I was thinking of making this into like a grenade launcher, maybe. I don't think I want to use this. This item cannot be scrapped. Oh, I love when you can't do that. Okay, so, as a tester, we're going to use that. Okay, so here's the deal. If you use the mini nukes and you have them get fired out of a minigun, be prepared to crash your game. I'm not going to actually do it because that's, like I said, crashing the game. I like the standard. Then I'm gonna come down here and have the gunner sight. outside the sea. And then we're going to make this shoot out. Missiles. Yeah, we'll have it shoot out. Yes. Exploding? And then you can do never ending. We're gonna do that just for demonstration's sake. What else do we have here? That and this. Okay, let's see here. No. Okay, let's just go with the recon school, shall we? I'm sorry if this video's a little, boring. Come in here and go all the way down to Liberty Prime. Ho-chai! And then we're going to have Never Ending on. And then we're going to add on Incinerator. Where's that at? Incinerator. This is going to be odd.
I'm going to run some diagnostics.
Go do that, man. You do you, man. Yes.
While you're tinkering. Nine.
Yep, you do you, buddy. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we're set. You know what? Because we can. Let's come in here. that. We are a sick. Nope, never mind. We changed the word. This one. There's one that changes. Into here. Oh shit, you can't do that? There we go. I don't know why I was punching that. I apologize. Okay, we're gonna come down here into spawners. Let's see. What do we want to use this on? How about we use it on... I'm not seeing anything I really want. How about we use it on... Feral ghouls. Okay, so we're just gonna make a whole bunch of these. And step one, to have some fun. Okay, so we'll put feral ghouls to the left. Minuteman up top. Then behemoth. Then a deathclaw. If you put on the feral ghouls, wouldn't you think?
I don't think we're up there.